Hey, tis Rich. I suppose I should first address the elephant in the room, that is, why this vid is entitled Volume 2 when there isn't a Volume 1 listed in our vid section. Well, for once, that's an easy question to answer. If you're not already aware, this is a collaboration with Josh over at the channel Josh Bearheart Cemetery Chats. He's presented Volume 1, so go check his vid out first. Subscribe whilst you're there if you haven't already, then head back over here. I am going to run through a quick recap, and there'll probably be a little overlap. So if you have already watched Josh's vid, then you can skip ahead to this timecode here, if you so wish. The idea for these vids came about due to a contribution Josh posted to the Paranormal Tedium Facebook group, Paranormal Truth, to which group member Mark Ferris left an intriguing reply. This then spawned a tangential... Fucking hell, Rich. This then spawned a tangential conversation between the three of us. One manic email exchange later, and here we are. If you want to get the full rundown and or contribute to Josh's original post, or to the group as a whole, consider joining Paranormal Truth. The link is down in the vid description. As Josh mentions at the start of his vid, the reason behind our chosen vid titles is that they're riffing on the title of an 1886 two-volume work by co-authors Edmund Gurney, Frederick W. H. Myers, and Frank Podmore, entitled Phantasms of the Living. These volumes go more into the spiritual and psychic ability side of things, and the three authors later became the beginnings of the Society for Psychical Research. Why we chose Phantasms of the Still Living will become clear in a moment. Mark's comment to Josh's post tells of his own research into the paranormal, which led him to people who related stories of their experience of thinking a still living loved one or family member were at home, were close by, or had passed by a room they were in. They'd heard their voice, heard familiar sounds or smelled scents associated with that person, but on investigation, they were, in fact, completely alone. Okay, those that skip forward will be here presently, so let's have a bit of a giggle. Ready? 3, 2, 1. And that's all you have to do to be in with a chance to win. This vid is going to be more of an extension of my Why Do People Think They See Ghosts vlog. I'll card it here and link it in the vid description so you can go check that out too. With regards to people thinking that they've seen, heard, or felt the presence of a still living family member at home when they were completely alone, I had a similar experience back in the late 80s, though I wasn't at home, nor was I alone. It was whilst I had a part-time job at Royal Fail. My dad also worked for them, but whereas I worked in the inward mail sorting section, he was a manager on the outward delivery side. When I first started working there, we were paid weekly and in cash. We got paid on Thursdays, and on those days, my dad, at the end of his shift, would come over to pick up the cash from me. This was so I wouldn't lose it down a chute or something. On one of those Thursdays, a co-worker standing next to me said, "Rich, your dad's here." So I turned and looked down the sorting office, and sure enough, there was my dad, walking down the shop floor from the far end. But it wasn't my dad. As this person got closer, we both realised that it wasn't actually my dad at all, but one of the industrial engineers that worked in the same building as him. For that few seconds after being told that it was my dad, I perceived my dad. He appeared to me to have the same walking gait, the same hairstyle, and the same slight tilt of his head when he walked. Now, if you were to put this person and my dad side by side, there would be virtually no similarities, other than the fact that they both had a similar hair colouring and both wore suits. A case of being primed, maybe? If so, then how would that explain my co-worker also thinking it was my dad? Within the paranormal community, this does have a name, bilocation. I'm not going to get into that here, but if you want to check out all the imaginative explanations some have for this, then take a look at the comments section on this post on the Quora website. Again, I've linked in the vid description. As mentioned in my aforementioned vlog, our brains are fucking amazing and can do phenomenal things. but they can be so very easily tricked, due to the process of how we perceive our reality. Optical and auditory illusions and pareidolia, as described in Josh's vid, are commonplace, as our brains only receive second-hand information about the physical world around us, in the form of electrical impulses sent from our senses via our nervous system. The brain then takes this impetus and compares it to previous information it has stored away to be able to, or at least try to, make sense of what it's received. This vid, which I've linked in the vid description, is a great example of that process in action. It was sent to me by the wonderful Hayley Stevens during an email exchange we had. I highly recommend you go check out the website hayleyisaghost.co.uk if you don't already know who Hayley is, also linked in the vid description. Of all our senses, the sense of smell is, by far, the best memory trigger. So when people state of a deceased family member or loved one, I could smell their perfume, cologne or what have you, so I knew it was them and that they were close by, could this just be triggered memories manifest? Our brains also try to make up for what's lacking. The blind spot in your vision, which all sighted people have, is a great example. We have it, but we're rarely aware of it, if at all. To find your blind spot in either eye, close one eye and hold up the opposite thumb. Position the thumbnail roughly in the centre of your vision, then focus on a point straight ahead, beyond your thumb. Now, slowly move your arm out, still focusing straight ahead, and stop when your thumb, or part of it, disappears. Oh. This is due to where the optic nerve is placed in the retina. You never see dark blobs or distortions where this occurs in either eye, but it is always there. Our brains just fill in the gap, like the content aware spot healer or fill function in Photoshop. Getting back to Mark's comment, the point he was getting at was, if our brains can be so easily tricked into thinking that someone who we know to be still alive is close by when they clearly aren't, how is this not the same process or engine, as Mark phrased it, to when people experience paranormal occurrences? After all, it is the same bioelectrical neurological process that's involved in both situations. If there were a difference, how could you possibly differentiate when the only real difference is in each individual's unique perception and understanding of life, death and reality? Now I know quite a few of you who watch our vids and or that have subscribed have had personal paranormal experiences, and I'll reiterate what I've oft stated. We're not here to explain, confirm or debunk that experience. We weren't there and we're not you. So how could we possibly pass comment? That task lies entirely with you. All we're trying to do is make people think and ask questions. So what's your take on this? Have you experienced a phantasm of the still living? Let us know down in the comments and we'll keep this conversation going. Alternatively, you could head over to the aforementioned Facebook group, Paranormal Truth, and join in there. If you like this vid, then please do give it a thumbs up and we'll keep doing our part one tiny vid at a time. We've also had word via other channels that YouTube has been randomly unsubscribing their viewers, so please do check to see if you're one of these people. If you have been unsubscribed or are not yet a subscriber, hit that subscribe button, remembering to click the bell icon to get notifications of when we upload more content. If you wish to contribute in the production of our content, then you can do this by donating to us via our Patreon page or by checking out our merch storefronts on Spreadshop. Details, you guessed it, can be found in the can be found in the vid description. Thanks for watching. Is that it? Have we done it? Oh.